Hey there everyone, this is your guy Rajat back again with yet another video about Angular, and in today's video we are going to learn about the templating system in Angular. Okay, so in today's video we are going to build this small to-do list. So here you can list down the task and then you can mark these tasks done, and also you will be notified which item you last acted upon. So this is a small cute example which we are going to design, and we are going to learn a hell lot about the templating system that comes with Angular. Now we have already learned that Angular applications are built as the combination or the collection of Angular components, and these components have two parts: the part where the business logic goes in, and this part is the class part, right? So you create classes like this, right? So this is the logic part, and then the component also has one more part which deals with the UI and the representation of what this class contains, right? So the display and the UI part is known as the template part. So the class part plus the template part makes up the entire component which Angular creates and then renders on the UI, right? So in today's video we are going to talk about the UI part, the template part. So without any further ado, we are going to boot up our new application. Okay, so let me close all of these things down. Go to stackblitz.com and create a new Angular application. So here is our application. Now we have to quickly get rid of this UI. So just go to this HTML file and delete the content. Save this thing. Come to app component TS and delete this property as well. Okay. So we are going to start with the interpolation syntax and representing facts from the class component to the template file. Okay. So let's suppose we have a property, class property, which is page title. Okay. And this page title is tasks. Okay, now I want to show this page title here. How can I do that? I can use the interpolation syntax for that. So in this HTML file you can write the valid HTML along with the constructs provided by the Angular framework. So what Angular does is it takes in this HTML file and then just replace all the Angular constructs with the process data. Okay, so we are going to create an h1 here. Okay, so this is vanilla HTML, and then we are going to use the interpolation syntax which is denoted by two curly braces. Okay, and then goes your property from the class. Okay, and this thing. So now you can see that it is getting the data from the class file. Okay, so this is how Angular combines the two individual parts and create one logical unit that is known as a component, right? So this is how you can control the entire life cycle and behavior and the UI of any Angular component by placing data in appropriate files. Now instead of creating this app.component.html file, you can also inline the HTML over here. So if you want to just inline things, you can just write your HTML here, page title, okay, and use template instead of template URL, and you will still get the same results. So you have two ways: you can inline the template part, or you can create an external file and use the template URL property. Okay, alright, so we are going to use an external file as we have got here. So now we need to create some task which we can show on the UI. Now in any Angular application, I mean in a real world application, you are going to have a proper class to represent your data, and that is something which we are going to do. So in order to represent any task, we have to create a model or a class that represents that data. We have got individual tasks which we can show, as we have seen here. So these are the data. Okay, so we have got three such data, right? We want to represent this particular thing, as one particular entity. So we can create classes. Okay, so create a normal TypeScript class, call it task. Okay, and in this task we are going to create a constructor which takes in some properties like title. Okay, then the done part to represent whether the task is completed or not. So it can either be true or false, right? Depending upon this, we can actually strike through the task in case it is done or this done property is true. Then we can also contain an ID. So the ID should go here. Okay, to uniquely represent any item. Okay, so this is going to be number. As of now, we are not going to put in the logic to ensure that the IDs are unique among all the elements of the task array. Okay, so this is how you can create stuff. So this is a shorthand notation to just take in the class member and initialize them from the constructor itself. So we have got a model for representing our data. Now we can create tasks like tasks, and it is going to be of type array of task. Okay, and then here you can actually create task. So new task. Okay, and you are going to import task from task.ts. okay, task. All right, so new task, then provide in the ID, any title, learn JavaScript, maybe the done property, which is as of now false because no task should be done in the start. Again, create two more tasks. Okay, so now we have got the data. Now we need to represent it on the UI. Now we are going to learn about a new construct which we have in Angular, and that is the ng4. Using ng4, we can iterate over any list to represent that particular repetitive data. How can we do that? So create one UL element. Okay, and first of all, create the boilerplate code UL and UL. Okay. Okay, so now use this notation *ng4. So this is a directive which Angular offers, and using this directive you can iterate over any list. Okay, so ng4 and this particular micro syntax, let task of tasks. Okay, so this task is something that is located here. Okay, so this should be task. Okay, not task. So this task property is being used in ng4, and it is going to iterate over all the elements of this task property from our class. And then we are going to create allies. Okay, as you can see that it has already created three ally elements because there are three elements in our task array. Then you can write your data here. So task is one such element from the entire array at any point of time, right? So if we want to use this task or properties of this particular task, I mean whatever that is on the current iteration, we can use task. So this is just a normal task or the normal item from the array, and all the properties that this particular item has are available in your template itself. Okay, so task dot title, and this is how you can easily represent the entire list. So this is how you use ng4 directive. You have iterated over a task and represented the data. Then we also want to show the check marks. Okay, to do that we are going to create one input, and the type of this particular input is going to be of checkbox. Okay, now we have got checkboxes. As of now, nothing happens. Now we want that upon clicking this checkbox, this item should get ticked off, and upon declicking or unchecking this checkbox, this item should restore to its original form, which is non-strike through. So to do that, we have to tap into the change event. Okay, so it has got the change event, which you can listen to. We have already talked about tapping into events that are being emitted from the components in the second video of the series. You can go back and watch that. Okay, so we are going to listen to the change event, and then here we are going to provide a statement. Okay, so whatever goes inside these double quotes is considered a statement. Angular consider whatever is between these two quotes as a statement to process. Okay, so we have got two things, statements and expressions. Okay, statement by their inherent nature can change the underlying data. Okay, so you can call functions here, and those functions can change data from this class. Okay, so whatever elements are there can be morphed into something else by those functions, which you can call here. Expressions on the other side should be pure, they should never change the data. So in your interpolation syntax, you use expressions. So whatever is there between the curly braces is the expression, and they should never change the data. They should never have any sort of side effect. So if I call page title, it should not change any data inside app.component.ts. It should never do that. So this is something which you need to consider, that whatever goes between the curly braces are known as expressions, and expression should not change any data. And when you are tapping into the events emitted from any component, you use statements, and statements can change the data. So we are going to create some function. We can call it whatever we want to, task status, and that it takes in the event. Okay, all right. So now we have to create this particular method in our component class. Okay, takes in an event, and this event is of type any. Now we can extract properties from the event, checked and value. Okay, from this event, as of now we have not specified any value. Now in order to tell which element got selected from the UI, we need some sort of definitive data using which we can make that particular decision. So we can use one more property, value, and then inside this value, first of all you should use this syntax. This syntax is the property binding. So input element has this property value, and you are binding some value to this property. Okay, so this is the syntax, and just use task.id, because here you can pass in the expression. Now if you go back and do the console logging here for checked and value, you will see the data. Go to console, okay, wipe out these errors, and then do this checked. Okay, it is not printing anything. So we have got a typo over here. So it should be change. Okay, the event which is being emitted from the input component is not change but change. So the D was not required actually, so it is change. Now if you do this, you will get the event. Okay, now here you can extract this checked and value property from the target. If you go over here, you will get the value, and you will get the checked status as well, which is over here. Okay, so we are using the destructuring syntax, event.target, and now you will get your values, true, false, and the ID 1. Okay, now we can get rid of this. Now we want to strike through the item which is being checked and undo the strike through when it is unchecked. How can we do that? In order to do that, in the model itself, we have to mark it as true, so as to tell that this item is completed. And if it is unchecked over here, then we have to restore it back to false, so as to represent that this item is not yet done. Okay, so it is as simple as doing this. So first of all, we are going to get the target ID. Okay, and that target ID is going to be parse int of value. Okay, we are parsing it back to the number because this value property gets converted into a string, and we want the numeric value in order to uniquely identify the item. So here we have got 1, 2, 3, but we know in array that we have got elements starting from 0. So our item number 1 or task number 1 is represented or is located at the index 0. So parse int value is going to give us 1 in case of first item, and we want the index to be 0 in this case. So hence we are going to decrement whatever we obtained from parse int value by 1, which will represent the item's exact location in this task array. And then once we have got the target ID, we can extract the task. This dot tasks and the element will be represented by target ID index. So the done property of the item located at this index should be marked by the checked status. So because the checked status is going to contain either true or false, true in case it is checked, false in case it is not checked. Okay, and we are done. Okay, so this thing says cannot find target ID. I think I have done a typo here. Now it is fine, but still the UI is not striking through the checked elements. What is happening? We need to use one more construct here that is known as ng class, using which you can actually append classes to your components on the UI. Okay, so wrap your title between a span and use the ng class syntax. So ng class, this is how you use this directive. And inside this, you can write the conditional statement. So if the task is done, then we are going to use the ternary operator from JavaScript here. So if task.done is true, then append this class done. Otherwise, append no class. Okay. So if the task.done is true, this class will be appended to it. Now, in order to target this class from the CSS, we can head over to appcomponent.css, and in here we can write that li.done is going to be text decorated as line through. Okay, this should be li span.done because we have contained the element inside span. So now it will work. Okay, so this is the required behavior. There is one more thing we want to do, that we want to show on the UI which element got updated recently. Okay, so we have to show the last updated item. Now go back to your app component and here create one more class member, and that will be last updated item index, and this index will contain the initial value of -1, which means that in the start of the application no item was modified, so it cannot be anything except -1, or you need some sort of value to represent the default state. In our case, I have taken the value of -1. As soon as the user interacts with the UI, the last updated item will change, right? So if I click on this thing, learn maths will be the last updated item in that particular case. If after interacting with this item, I interacted with this item, this item would become that last interacted with element. Okay, so now here after the toggle status changes, I can do this dot last updated index, and this will be equal to the target ID, correct? So now I can actually retain the value of last modified item. Now I can create one more method to get the last updated task. I can write something like that, get last updated task. Okay, and this is a class method. Here I can do this, return this dot tasks and this dot last updated item index. So I will get the last updated task. Now I have this task that when this value is -1, I do not want to show that row showing the last updated item, because at this point of time no item was interacted with, so I cannot show the last updated items row. Once the user has interacted with the UI, I have this thing last updated item index set to something other than -1. In this case, I need to show. How can I make this sort of conditional work on the UI? For this thing, I have to use one more Angular construct that is known as ngif. And this is a directive I can use in order to render conditional UI. So I'll go back to app.component.html class. Here I am going to create a paragraph element. Okay. Last updated item. So how can I get the last updated item? As we have seen that using interpolation syntax, we can call expressions. Now we can also call functions. So if we are going to call function in here, Angular first of all is going to process that function, execute that function and get some value out of it, and then it will convert that value into a string. So you can also call functions between these curly braces. So here I am going to call this function get last updated index, I mean last updated task. Okay, and just the title of it should be rendered along with this particular prefix. And as you can see here that as of now, when the user has never interacted with the application, this particular thing is going to return us nothing, because at this particular point of time there is no last updated item. We do not want to show it, and we know that we have to use ngif. How can I do that? I will go back to the paragraph element, do this ngif, and here I can use the statement, and inside these quotes I can write the conditional. So if the last updated item index is not equals to -1, show it, otherwise don't show this particular UI. Okay, so as of now there is nothing. As soon as I interact with this thing, it will become visible and it shows the exact item which I last interacted with. So if I click on this learn math becomes the last interacted item, and if I do this, learn JavaScript becomes one. If I unclick this, learn math become one. Now you get the idea. So this is how you can use ngif to make conditional rendering. So there is one more thing you have to pay attention to. So we have passed in these properties, right? These properties to this element. So you may think that this particular type property, value property, is just the HTML attribute. This is certainly not the case. In Angular, you have got cases where there is one-to-one mapping between the attributes, I mean the HTML attributes, and the properties. When you want to bind the properties, you use this sort of syntax, which is like using these square brackets. There are certain attributes for which the equivalent properties are available, and there are many other cases where there are none. For example, if I want to provide the area label for this component, I cannot do this area label, and I cannot do this because it is complaining that can't bind to area label because there is no such property, right? And I just want to create this HTML attribute on this element. In order to do this, I have to use attr.area label, and then I can get that sort of HTML attribute on my element. If I go back, I can show you inspect. Okay, so here you can see that area label. Let me expand it a little bit more. So here you can see that area label is mark completed, right? Earlier it was reporting an error because there was no one-to-one mapping for this area label thing, right? So there is a difference between HTML attributes and DOM properties. Whatever that are listed here are generally DOM properties. So you have to keep that thing in mind. In order to define and change the attributes, you have to use this attr.notation in order to pass or change the HTML attributes directly. Also do something like this. Remove this thing. Okay. And you can argue that you still get this area label, right? Mark completed over here. But the catch is that in HTML attribute, you cannot make the template binding work. Template binding only works when you are dealing with the properties. Okay. So if I want to provide area label as the title of the task, task.title, right? If I want to do this thing, I cannot do this because this is not a valid property. So I cannot bind anything or any value to it. So if I do this and go back to here, I will see that my task.title is not processed because it is not a valid property. So that is one thing you have to keep in mind. Template binding only works with properties and events. So here I can only provide strings because this thing only gets rendered when the component is initializing, and after that HTML attributes are set and done. They will never be touched upon once they are rendered initially. So I can very well provide a string value here, but the template binding will not work. Now I will get the value here again. Okay, mark completed, because this is just a string. But if I want to provide something like mark learn JavaScript task done, something like that, where I want to substitute the title in this mark completed thing, then I have to resort to the attr.notation, attr area label, and now I can bind and use the properties over here. So using this way, I can get my property binding to work again. So that is why you have to use this attr notation. Now we have learned a significant deal of rendering UIs and using various constructs provided by Angular in order to get the job done. These are some of the very well-known and very basic controls using which you can render many sort of UIs, but there are certain other niceties you can use from time to time. Those topics I will introduce at the end of this particular series because I think that those features are mostly nice to have. With this much knowledge, you can actually build a full-fledged UI with which you can allow the users to have pretty complex interactions and you can gather the data. In the next part of this series, we are going to learn about forms and we are going to collect some data using forms. So make sure you subscribe to this channel in case you are interested in learning more about this Angular thing, because we are going to get very deep into Angular forms. I see you guys over in the next video. Don't forget to like this video.